Hello, everybody, and welcome to yet another episode of the TBOD Extra Points. I am the Quim Ninja. I am here to kick ass and chew gum. I'm all out of gum, motherfuckers. And with me today is eremenko.
I just came to chat, but, you know.
He came to chat and chew gum, and he's all out of gum, too. I'm going to put the Nintendo scope down. It's just such a novelty. I've not held one of these since. It seemed a lot bigger.
Yeah.
This shrunk.
I did put it through the wash on a high setting, so it's possible.
Right. I see. Well, it's still badass. If you want to know what I'm on about, I'm looking like a bit of a tool. So, yeah, check out the video if you're only listening to the audio. But we're not here to talk about the Nintendo scope. We are here to talk about the days of yore, though. And how the days of yore may not necessarily apply in modern day gaming. You may remember, if you cast your mind back into the ether, that mascot platform gaming was quite a thing back in the days of the Super Nintendo and the N64, the PlayStation, with people like Banjo-Kazooie, Donkey Kong,
Crash Bandicoot.
Spyro, Gex, Croc, the list goes on. It seemed that every single developer and publisher had their own mascot for one platform or another. But there were two back in the day that stood aloft the rest, reigning on a platform-raised throne. and, you know, they were the King Dons. And they were Mario and Sonic.
Team Sonic, baby.
So, obviously in recent years, it's not been so much Mario versus Sonic. One of these mascots has fallen from grace, whilst the other continues to soar on his platform made of gold. So the question I wanted to ask you, because, you know, you've played both of these games and a lot of these games extensively, both Mario and Sonic. Why do you think it is that Mario has stood the test of time and Sonic seems to have faded from relevance as of late? In fact, almost complete relevance, if you think the fact that Sega's shut down now.
It's a really difficult question to answer because for me, growing up, I was a Sega boy. I was a Sega fanboy. I had a Master System. I had a Mega Drive. And I did not have...
Sometimes you mastered, master-sisted your Mega Drive.
I did, occasionally, now and again. But yeah, I did not have a NES. I did not have a SNES. I have a SNES now. And I have an N64. I have a 3DS and obviously Wii and stuff. And, you know, I'm a big Nintendo fan now. But Sega, obviously... they're not there anymore, you know. I've got Saturn, I've got a Dreamcast, and I loved those consoles. I thought they were fantastic. Admittedly, the Sonic games on the later consoles weren't that great. And I think therein lies the key to Sonic's downfall. And, you know, given how important the mascots were in that day and age, possibly even the key to Sega's downfall, didn't make the transition to 3D worlds very well, where Mario, Nintendo nailed it from the first time of asking. You can play any Mario game. I defy you to play any Mario game now and not have fun. You could go back and play the original Super Mario and have loads of fun. You could go and play Mario 64, which I think was the first 3D iteration of Mario, and still have a shitload of fun with it. And even right up to, you know, the most recent fully 3D worlded Mario on Wii U. I don't know
the name of it. Is that not 3D World, isn't it? Super
Mario 3D. That was on 3DS, which is also great.
My mind's blanking.
Yeah, but they've continued both lines of Mario and they've done it so well. The last fully 3D one I played was Super Mario Galaxy 2, which I know you've played as well, and it's just a fucking brilliant game.
DualShock 4.
Yeah. on Interestingly PC. Enough. I actually have both Super Mario Galaxy and Super Mario Galaxy 2 and they're brilliant, and New Super Mario Brothers Wii as well, you know, where they continued to create the 2D platforming game and they've absolutely mastered it. There's no denying that those platforming games are the most joyous and fun to play and easy to pick up. They've put new features in, they've added multiplayer, you can play with your friends, and every single time, like I say, Nintendo have just managed to pull it out of the bag with those games. And Sonic, admittedly, Sonic 1 through Sonic and Knuckles, all of the 2D games were absolutely class. Sonic 3D wasn't so hot. And then Sonic Adventure, the Sonic Adventure games, they were just all over the place. Like, they really were. I think I played Sonic Adventure 1 and 2 on the Dreamcast, and they were okay, but they were just okay, you know. Mario, just brilliant. I mean, I don't know, obviously you grew up as a Nintendo fanboy.
I did, yes.
You feel the same way?
I do. I'm a plumber lover. I'm proud. For me, Mario...
You'd love each other's plumbers.
Yeah. Oh, man, that's definitely going to be a song. Wow.
We should love each other's plums. No, we can't say that. Oh, my God.
Okay. Let's get back on track, people. So, yes, Mario. I mean, looking even back to the kind of 2D games, I say this in a completely unbiased view, but Mario was better than Sonic.
completely unbiased.
My answer is Sonic shit, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
No.
In all fairness,
Sonic games were fun, as were Mario. But Mario always had a slight kind of extra bit to their game, so they'd have puzzle elements, etc. Sonic, in essence, was all about running and doing this.
Yeah, it was a speed game.
Exactly, and they were all like that. They were all speed games. And each Mario would bring something different to the table. And they keep doing that. They keep bringing new elements in and trying something completely different with Mario and adding more in to kind of diversify what he's up to. Whereas every single Sonic game is essentially a speed game. And, you know, when you've done, you know, it's like somebody who just keeps kind of just doing the same thing over and over again. Eventually, they'll lose enthusiasm for it. And similarly, the people who experience whatever it is they're doing over and over again will lose enthusiasm for it. And I think that's what's happened with Sonic. Because his original games were based on this one thing, and, you know, the first couple of games were that, and they've just stuck with that.
Yeah,
that's what I think has cost Sonic in the long run, because he's not diversified away from just being run as fast as you can. And as gamers have matured and wanted more intricate and complex things, Mario has provided that with the crazy levels that it puts in, the different perspectives, the new gameplay mechanics. And really, Sonic has just stayed as a runner.
When they have tried to diversify it, it hasn't worked out for them. So in Sonic Adventure, you know, they introduced the Chao Garden and stuff, and that was just weird. And then more recently, they've brought out Sonic Blast
or Sonic Boom.
Yeah,
sold
which is
450,000 copies,
but has been absolutely panned across the board. Really,
yeah,
it's not been a popular game.
Well, 450,000 copies is a terrible amount of games to sell.
I mean,
the lowest selling Sonic game ever.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Wow, poor Sonic.
Yeah.
Although, you know, I would argue that Sonic TV shows were better than the Mario TV show.
I would probably have to concur.
And the Sonic movie was better than the
Sonic
Mario movie.
Movie.
Yeah, there isn't one, but it's still better than the Mario movie.
Again, I would have to concur. But we're not judging the movies.
No,
yet.
We're not. We're judging the games. And you're right. Mario has always been a better game.
It's always tried new things.
More solid foundations. And I mean, Mario has been around longer than Sonic as well. Obviously, Mario originated as Jumpman in the Donkey Kong arcade games, right back at almost the very beginning of gaming.
Yeah.
He's still going strong. Like, that guy must be a canny ripe old age now.
Yeah.
Still,
unless he was only like 2 and had a mustache in that very
true.
First game.
I think he probably did have a mustache when he was 2. I've still never seen him fix a sink, though.
Yeah, I would definitely not pay his rates. Like, you've seen how many gold coins he wants, you know? And he's always taking mushrooms. He'd be a terrible plumber, but the point is he can deal with all the situations thrown at him.
Yeah.
And he gets a lot of different situations thrown
at him. And he's reinventing himself more times than Madonna.
Exactly, yeah. And he never, ever falls down steps. He knows how to take his cape off.
He does.
And that's when he gets hit by a Goomba.
Just falls off.
Yeah.
Just falls off.
So, yeah, I mean, for me, I think all comes down to the diversity from those first games. I think that's kind of been Mario's strength and at the same time Sonic's weakness, which, you know, is unfortunate because those kind of old school battles, playground battles of, you know, who's better, Mario or Sonic, and you'd have those arguments in the playground. Well, Mario's better than Sonic. No way. You're insane. Sonic's better than Mario. Kids don't have that. Won't have that. It's just Mario. What do you play now, Mario?
Yeah, well, yeah, definitely.
Or Call of Duty. Who's better?
But you still have mascots to an extent. You know, the Xbox's mascot is Master Chief.
Sure, but that's rated M for mature. It's not a true kids game, is it?
Yeah, but there's still kids still play it. You know what I mean? Kids still play Call of Duty. Absolutely, they shouldn't. And I guess like Sony kind of struggle for a mascot a little bit. They still in the campaign, advertising campaign for the PS4, they hinted at bringing back Crash Bandicoot. And I guess in a way, the console wars are won now more by the studios that they have under their banner.
Well, I think, and again, this is probably, we're great at going off topic, but stick with that. I think that it's not won by kids anymore. It's not about attracting kids to play it. That happened. That created a generation of gamers. That generation of gamers is us.
Yeah.
And now it's all about keeping us buying the consoles, you know, just as much as the younger generation.
I think you're absolutely right. I think the younger generation.
And that's why the Drakes and the Master Chiefs, et cetera, they sell the consoles.
Yeah,
they're
absolutely.
Console sellers because they're the games which are aimed at us and rated for us.
And that's why, probably not correctly, that's why most video game heroes are white 20 to 30 something men.
Yeah.
That's what they that's I guess how they think they're where they think their audience is.
But to me, I'll always be a 45-year-old fat plumber with a mustache.
And his lanky brother.
What? Nah, screw him.
He's that's you.
I was never
Never Luigi.
Never Luigi. I'm the older brother, innit?
Well, I suppose. But I like the way Luigi's jump, especially in New Super Mario Brothers, like he has that sort of floatier jump.
Yeah, screw that. I'm all about wearing red overalls, me.
So you never want to play as Toad either?
Nah, he's tiny. He's tiny and rubbish. I'm all about playing Donkey Kong in Mario Kart. Mario in
I mean,
Mario.
That's probably worth mentioning as well. Mario franchises so much better than Sonic. Yeah, there was the crossover Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games, but in terms of...
You were only ever Sonic when you were doing a running game.
Yeah, in terms of selling
That's exactly it. He doesn't
units.
Diversify. Even
just
the Olympic
runs.
Games,
he can't jump.
He just does the 100-meter sprint. And that's
but
it.
Mario, obviously, there's so many... He appears in so many titles, and there's so many titles that carry his name. Right across the board of the Nintendo range, and that in of itself is a hell of an achievement.
Yeah, definitely. I think they've just marketed it really well, and Sega have just kind of fallen. It's like, I think it's, you know, as much as you can say that Nintendo are out of touch and they just keep, leaning on these characters, they made such strong characters that they can, to a degree.
I would never say that the character of Mario is a particularly strong one. It's
more identifiable, though. You know, people,
yeah.
You know, I think that they've just made such a recognizable character there.
Absolutely. But he's simple. He's fairly two-dimensional, even in the 3D games.
Sure.
Just, you know what you're going to get from Mario. It's not like... He's not a great conversationalist, but he does stand out for sure.
The strong silent type.
Absolutely. And sometimes that's a winner. So is Link.
Yeah, exactly. Well, they're essentially the same character, if you think about
it. Yeah, if you go really deep down.
Yeah, they're both few words looking to save a princess. But one has a pipe. One has a sword.
And there sword. Yeah. We've just analysed Nintendo's success story there.
So yeah, not only have we worked out the whole Sonic thing, we've now sorted out Mario and Link there.
I'm still a Sonic fanboy though.
Yeah, he's Sonic for life. I'm Mario till I die, bitches. And with that, I think we shall knock this extra points on the head. If you have any comments about what we've spoken about in any of these videos, about Mario versus Sonic, or any of the other stuff we've discussed, episodic content, etc., let us know. You can hit us up at Teabag or Die on Twitter. That's where you'll find us. You can go to Facebook as well. You'll occasionally find us there. Just type in Teabag or Die. And of course, if you want to hear us in just audio format and carry us around in your pocket, check us out on iTunes too.
Just before we go, a quick thanks to BalBod for animating our intro and making us look slick as fuck.
Yeah, thanks BalBod. Looks awesome.
Check him out. He's on YouTube under
BalBod. He's the Mario of animators, you see.
That's right, yeah. He's going to be around for a long time.
Long time. All right, thanks, guys. Thanks for listening and watching. Take care.
Bye.